former Iranian diplomat Mehrdad Khonsari, who's joining us from the British capital. Mr. Khonsari, always good to have you with us, sir. Now, first of all, how likely is it that Ms. Zaghari-Ratcliffe will be allowed to leave the country soon?
Well, I think people have made too many predictions, you know, which have proven wrong. I think that the chances are more than ever before, but unless, of course, there are certain unknown factors which people really don't know. But I think Iran has every incentive now for wanting to end this particular matter, because especially now that it needs the United Kingdom to try and sort of support its cause in other matters, most prominently the nuclear issue, and wants to get issues of this nature out of the way so that it can resume better relations with the United Kingdom and end this matter, end this saga, because it has no further benefit for them.
Absolutely not. And her prison term has now finished. And you mentioned those other matters, and she is going back to court in a couple of days. Is it the suggestion then that perhaps the outcome of that court trial depends on diplomacy between Tehran and London?
I think you're absolutely right there. And there will be a lot of behind-the-scenes activities in the course of the next week. And the Iranians are anxious to try and extract as many promises as they can from the British government, because especially now, you know, that the Europeans have taken a hard stand against Iran over its, you know, over its demands for a return to the JCPOA. They are anxious that Britain does not support the European position and the hard attitude that they have. And they will be maneuvering in order to try and see how they can come about to a special agreement with England and with the United Kingdom, that is. And that is the kind of thing that they will be jockeying for. But in any event, keeping her on longer just serves no purpose for Iran anymore, and it could result in further bad will, which they don't want to have at this particular stage.
Now, Mr. Khonsari, finally, you've mentioned, of course, the nuclear deal that is looking to be revived. But there's another issue at play here as well, isn't there, that some commentators are focusing on. And this is the £400 million owed to Iran by the United Kingdom. I know that you will not want to speculate on whether that's had any factor, but do you think that amount of money could have any bearing in what happens next for Ms. Zaghari-Ratcliffe?
Obviously, you can't discount this particular issue that you raised, but you know, in the greater scheme of things, £450 million is not a huge amount of money that can tilt the Iranian government one way or another. But obviously, it is an issue; it needs to be addressed, and it has taken a long time for it to come to any fruition. I think that, from a British point of view, making a concession on that is a lot easier than other things that the Iranians might be wanting to have.
Okay, Mehrdad Khonsari, former Iranian diplomat, thank you for your time. Thank you.